الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earths and the heavens, the king of the day of judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. ونشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. Indeed, we bear witness that there is no Lord but the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. I remind myself and remind you to be pious, to be God-conscious, to heed the orders of the Almighty Azza wa Jal when He orders us, when He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Oh, you believe, be God-conscious and die in no way except in the way of Islam. Oh, you believe, be God conscious, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow, and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He knows best what you do. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our gathering, forgive our sins, guide our steps, and keep us steadfast. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, in two different places in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Al-Ahqaf and in Surah Al-Naml, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes His blessings upon His servants, and then offers a prayer subhanahu wa ta'ala in the tongue of the insan, the human being, to remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him, and to remind us and remind everybody the responsibility that comes with the gratitude that is afforded to all these blessings from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Ahqaf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the order to the human being, reminding him from the day they were born, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا. We have ordered the human being to do righteousness to his parents, for she carried him with a hardship, and she delivered him with a hardship, and she maintained him in his youth 30 months until حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَبَلَغَ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. Until he stood his development, and now he is 40 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, says, قَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْ وَعَلَى وَالِدَيْ وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ وَأَصْلِحْ لِي فِي دُرِّيَّتِي إِنِّي تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ وَإِنِّي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So in this version, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to say on the tongue of the human being, O Allah, grant me the ability to thank your blessings upon me and upon my parents, and grant me the ability so that I do righteousness that pleases you, O Allah, and give me the fixing needed for me and on my offspring. O Allah, I have returned to you, I have repented to you, and indeed, I am amongst the believers. And then in Surah An-Naml, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam blessings and powers that were never granted to anybody else. For Sulaiman alayhi salam prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him mulk that was unlike any other mulk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him the power to speak to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the power to move the jinn, and the power to move the creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created as a pathway for him to do righteousness. And when Sulaiman alayhi salam was walking with his troops and his horses, he was able to hear the ant warning its own fellows to move away from the path of Sulaiman, for they may not see you and they may crush you in their path. It is at that moment that he felt the depth and expressed the gratitude of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him that has not been given to anybody else. فَتَبَسَّمَ ضَاحِكًا مِّن قَوْلِهَا وَقَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَالِدَيْ وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ وَأَدْخِلْنِي بِرَحْمَتِكَ فِي عِبَادِكَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Oh Allah, same thing, grant me the ability to thank your blessings, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those that you have been blessed me with, and upon my parents, and give me the ability to do righteousness that pleases you, oh Allah, and enter me, notice this, and enter me with your mercy, for nothing comes from us, nothing comes from us because we did, so we deserve. It's only with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once the sincerity has been fulfilled, once the full intent to be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nobody else, once we have completed the tenets of Iman, وَأَدْخِلْنِي بِرَحْمَتِكَ فِي عِبَادِكَ الصَّالِحِينَ, to be among your righteous servants. My dear brothers and sisters, the scholars say that you cannot attain shukr, gratitude, thankfulness, gratefulness, until you achieve three components. What they call urfanul ihsan, to recognize the magnitude of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, coupled with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and coupled with the fear to transgress against him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second, al-i'tirafu bi ni'mati al-mun'imi ala wajhi al-khudu'i wal-hub. That not only do you recognize from within, but you start to perform in accordance with those blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afforded you, and then consistent with the actual understanding of the word shukr in Arabic. It is a shakar is duhuru athar in ni'ma. That when you do something and then you see it in a different version, improved and better, that is the effect of shakar or shukr, which from which it comes. And so the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to appear on you. Like the scholars say, عَلَى قَلْبِ الْعَبْدِ شُهُودًا وَمَحَبَّةً وَعَلَى لِسَانِ الْعَبْدِ ثَنَاءً وَاعْتِرَافًا وَعَلَى جَوَارِحِ الْعَبْدِ إِنْقِيَادًا وَطَاعَةً. That it should appear in the heart, love and following and feeling the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, and on your tongue with the repetitive remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings upon you, and with your actions following the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying His commandments subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ensuring that the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you is utilized in the very way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended it to be. That is, and only then would you be truthful in your meanings of gratitude and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اعملوا آل داود شكرا. Do with the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the gratitude, with the thanksgiving, through the actions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to do. When we look at the blessings of this ibadah of shukr, first, it is one of the characteristics of the believers. You don't attain iman, true iman, until you have cultivated the meaning of shukr in your life, in your heart, in your mind, in your tongue, in everything that you do. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ كُلُّ أَمْرِهِ خَيْرٌ أَوْ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءٌ شَكَرٌ فَكَانَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرٌ فَكَانَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he's describing, he says, the matter of the believer is all good. For when he is blessed with a blessing, he is in a state of gratitude. And that will be good for him. And we will see later how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this compounded impact of shukr on your life. And if you are hit with a calamity, you are patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tied the belief and the iman with shukr and sabr. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. That the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are only attained by those who attain iman through their shukr and through their sabr. And when you look and you see, how is it in a verse when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes about the munafiqeen and those who repent and give up their ways of staying away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he makes the final statement subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. Why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subject you to punishment if you truly are grateful and you're believing? In this place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings shukr even before iman. Because knowing the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, attaining the impact of them on you, is your pathway to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to believe in Him. In Surah Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي شَدِيدٌ. If you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will grant you more, but if you become ungrateful or commit kufr, indeed the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe. But here it's shakartum wa kafartum, as if it's a meaning to tie the meaning of iman that comes from a heart that is thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is also a cause for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only is it a characteristic of the believers, it's a cause for the blessings and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. If you're grateful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased. And it protects you from punishment for being ungrateful. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ, like we said. And it is a cause for more blessings. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عَزَّ وَزَلْ وَسَنَجْزِي الشَّاكِرِينَ. And another place, وَسَيَجْزِي اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. When we look at the meaning of the word الشَّكُور, which was one of the words of the Asma, the blessed names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the scholars say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described also His servants as shakur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَا الشَّكُور. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, describes Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala as shakur. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّا الْحَزَنِ إِنَّا رَبَّنَا لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. And another place, وَاللَّهُ شَكُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. They say the difference is, when you're a servant, you take from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and blessings, He make you able to perform the ibadah of shukr. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, gives you, and He is Most High of infinite generosity and blessings, that He is grateful subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's a difference between He who takes and His role is to perform shukr, and between the Most High, the Almighty Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who gives, and yet his blessings extend to him, being this rewarding is much better. It's like when Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala gives you the chance to live this life. And you may be grateful for it, for indeed it's our lot to figure out how to be grateful and truthful to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. But the reward is an eternal life. Not just those 50 years or 80 years or as many years as you're given as your lot on this life. For the magnitude by which Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala rewards is limitless. And it's a Jannah, عرضها السماوات والأرض. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم في كلام في الحديث القدسي أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes what he is prepared for those who are the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see it in the hadith, when anything that you do that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the blessings to do is rewarded in tremendous amount. If you mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إذا ذكرني عبدي في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منه ولا يذكرني عبد في نفسه إلا ذكرته في ملأ من ملائكتي ولا يذكرني في ملأ إلا ذكرته في الرفيق الأعلى سبحانه وتعالى. You just humbly mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention you to his angels subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a gathering, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention you in the highest of gatherings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فأولئك كان سعيهم مشكورا. That those who truly seek the hereafter and their hearts and they and وسعى لها سعيها, and he does the responsibility that comes with wanting the hereafter, and his heart is full of iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards them. وكان سعيهم مشكورا جنة عرضها السماوات والأرض. Indeed, this is a calling for us, my dear brothers and sisters, to cultivate, to build this ibadah of shukr. Yes, we may be reminded culturally and in a society with that event once a year, but it means far more to us than it does by being just a dinner or by just being an occasion to remember. But rather, it should be a ibadah that we exercise. It should be a way of life that we live constantly with every moment, from the moment you open your eyes in the morning. أَصْبَحْنَا وَأَصْبَحَ الْمُلْكُ لِلَّهِ. For you could have passed in that brief period of sleep. And so on and so forth. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, gives us and gives us the blessings. And then he gives us the order to thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And reminds us that our thanks are but only for our own good. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not benefit nor is harmed subhanahu wa ta'ala with anything that we do. وَمَنْ شَكَرَ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ. This ibadah is important and a must for us because it's for our own willing well-being. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, the generous, the kind, gives us the chance to thank him. In the verses we started with, رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ. Oh Allah, give me the pathway so that I can learn how to thank you subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he tells you that he is pleased with you. وَإِن تَشْكُرُ يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. And then he gives you the chance to make it multitudes. وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. What a beautiful meaning of all of these activities that we do that allows us to benefit, to learn and grow and cultivate this ibadah of ta'a. Lastly, my dear brothers and sisters, the scholars talk about what they call wajibun ni'mah. the responsibility that comes with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the fulfillment of that responsibility, we can't not use the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that which pleases Him. But it has to be in kind. For you can't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your health and for your time and for your wealth by just, let's say, doing sadaqah alone and leaving it without anything else. For the health that you are given, you are responsible to commit to the calling of the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the time that you have, you are to spend it and expend it and use it in order to make the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala high. And for the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given you, to utilize it so that you can make Islam and the mission you're entrusted with better and more. You can't just give a few dollars thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings of the eyesight or the ear, the hearing, if you're not using it for that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or if you're using it to undo that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed upon you. And as we heard a few days ago from our Shaykh Moro, Allah Yajzil Khair, when he talked about Surah Al-Duha, and he concluded how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was waiting for the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last of the orders that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Many of us look at this sometimes and think it's about using the blessings. And that is true. That's one of its meanings. But here, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the surah started, he was distraught because he wasn't receiving the wahy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran of the Mawla Azza wa Jal. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى, that we are still taking care of you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you are the chain in that chain of islah and righteousness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribes upon all of humanity, and that your role, O Muhammad, to take the most of the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the wahi, which is the Quran, which is the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for you to be the carrier of that responsibility. وَأَمَّا بِنَعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ اُدْعُوا إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِدَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ وَمَنْ أَفْضَلُ مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. Those who call for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the essence of what we should be doing in thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we start by recognizing it, we start by mentioning it in alhamd and in a shukr. But it can't stop there. It has to be translated into the very deeds that we commit and in the very words and that we make actions and be the actualization of the guidance of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala in our lives. Then and only then do we truly fulfill the meaning of shukr. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who are shakirin, to make us amongst those who understand and believe and live the meaning of shukr. Those who make the shukr, inshaAllah, their pathway to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their pathway to the tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their pathway to the ultimate prize from the most generous subhanahu wa ta'ala, the jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I say this and ask Him forgiveness. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. استغفر الله العظيم رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، والصلاة والسلام على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear respected brothers and sisters, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the prophets عليهم السلام, the word of shukr is something that we see very often. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Nuh alayhi salam, He said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. And when He described Ibrahim alayhi salam, إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا حنيفة ولم يكن من المشركين شاكرا لأنعمه. And when our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of the more amazing stories of his life, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Aisha radiallahu anha was asked after his passing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what have you seen of the matters of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that is amazing? And she would respond radiallahu anha, and what is of his matters is not amazing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then she describes a moment that she has witnessed with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when in a cold, dark night he would come into his bed, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until his skin touches the skin of Aisha. And then he would turn to Aisha radiallahu anha and he would say, "O Aisha, dharini ata'abbadu rabbi. Would you give me the chance to worship my Lord?" A kind prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he knows it's the right of Aisha for him to be with her, yet he asks her permission. And her response is nothing less. For radiyallahu anha, she would say, "Wallahi inni uhibbu qurbaka ya Rasulillah, walakinna hawak afdal." That I love your closeness to me, but what you wish for is more beloved to me than what I want. And he would stand sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he would pray. And she would describe him radiallahu anha, and she would say that the minute he starts reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his tears will flow until they wet his beard. And then he would continue until he would make the ruku'. And when doing ruku', his tears are filling his face until they wet the place in which he would make his sujood. And he would do his sujood sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until the hours of the morning comes in, when people come to wake him up or to ask him to call the prayer of Fajr. And so the companion who did was in wonder. He said, "O Prophet of Allah, Allah forgave your sins before and after. Why are you doing this?" And he would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Afala akunu abdan shakura." Why wouldn't I be a thankful servant? That is the essence, my dear brothers and sisters, sincerity and love and submission to the Almighty Azza wa Jal, translated into action and deed and word that is constantly aligned with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in fulfillment of His mission. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the strength and the iman to be thankful, to be grateful, to show our gratitude to the Almighty Azza wa Jal by everything that we think, by everything that we say, by everything that we do. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us messengers of peace and harmony to our people in this society and beyond. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and guide us. Allahumma afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Anta maulana fansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma ahdina wahdi bina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Wazakkiha maulaya. Anta khayru man zakkaha. Anta waliyaha wa maulaha. Ibadallah. Inna allaha ya'muru bil adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dil qurba. Wa yanha anil fahshai wal munkari wal baghi. يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وقوموا إلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.